The thing is, when we talk about smell, some people, especially those who have their smell intact, do not seem to realize how much of a disability it can be not to be able to perceive any odor at all. Because we take for granted our sense of smell. And for many people, smell is entirely for enjoyment. In other words, it's for perfumes. They don't think it has any real functional role it plays in their lives, but that's not true. A key role of olfaction in our lives is, olfaction is the sense of smell, by the way. And a key role it plays is that of safety. For example, you can walk into your house and perceive a gas leak and you say, oh, gas is smelling. And you go to the kitchen and shut off the gas immediately. An anosmic person doesn't have that warning signal. And go to the kitchen, put on the gas, and the house is in flames. So safety, beyond just smelling gas leaks and noxious chemicals, it also helps you to assess food. Many times you bring out, maybe especially when there's no light, you bring out food from the freezer and you say, oh, this smells bad. You're going to throw it away. An anosmic person doesn't perceive that. He's going to eat that food, doesn't realize that that food is rotten. And that can lead to food poisoning and all that. So olfaction is a warning signal. It keeps us safe in dangerous situations. Beyond that, it also helps in bonding, in recognizing people around you, and in self-care as well. In fact, one of the problems that anosmic people have is many of them pull into social isolation because they do not feel confident in their self-care. In other words, if I have bad breath, I might not know because I'm anosmic. Or if I have a body odor, if my armpit is smelling, I'm not going to know that I have that odor. And then I just notice that people around me are pulling away. People don't visit me anymore. Nobody wants to talk to me. I don't understand what is going on. Unless you have friends and family, people close to you, to point out to you that, oh, there's this smell or there's this odor from here. So those are some of the social problems, the safety problems. And then, yes, in taste. Olfaction plays a big role in how you actually taste food. We don't only perceive from anteriorly, from the front of our nose, we actually perceive from the back of the nose as well. So when you put food in your mouth, part of what you enjoy in the food is that the aroma of that food goes behind the mouth into the nose and you perceive it, and that contributes a lot to flavor. So anosmic patients often complain that eating food now feels like eating cardboard. They don't enjoy the taste, they don't enjoy the flavor. In fact, people say up to 90% of what you enjoy as the taste or the flavor of food is actually from the sense of smell. When the sense of smell is not there, you just have salty, sour, sweet. There's no blend of that to give you flavor. And so it affects people's desire to eat. For example, the person who says eating food is now like eating cardboard has no real desire to eat. Ultimately, this can lead to malnutrition for some patients and other problems like obesity, overeating in order to try and compensate for the lack of taste. Maybe if I take this. And that can lead to obesity on the other end of the spectrum, among other problems.